lecture series, and that particular lecture series is there. So I start with the polymerization, that particular polymerization itself. And polymerization itself is one of the process where the polymers are formed. So today we discuss about the different polymers, how their mechanism occurs. So polymers are the monomer of different units. So in this case of the polymers, different monomers combine with each other and form a linkage. So that's high molecular weight compounds are formed. Simple example, the polyethylene, in which the ethylene undergo the process of the polymerization and that will convert it into the polyethylene. Now similarly, in case of the nylons, those nylons are the polymer of dicarboxylic acid and diamines. So those are the example, hexamethyl diamine and as well as that dicarboxylic acid, hexane dioic acid. Similarly, in case of the polyester itself, that contains the amine group and that is the ester group. So how we can have the ester group? That is the very simple, that carboxylic group of organic compounds, in which the carbon double bond oxygen and OH is present. So carboxylic group when combined with alcohols, we have to see hydroxy containing compounds. Hydroxy group is there. So when polyester, that is the example, and almost most of the synthetic fibers are the polyester. Polyester is the name, what was the chemical name, but generally in all they called is polyester. So polyester is the big, this is the name given by the peoples, but chemically the name is polyesters. So polyesters are also the polymers. Now one more thing is there, if suppose we have the two or more monomers and then they combine with each other. However, I have given the example of the nylons in which two monomers link with each other and generates and eliminates small molecule. In case of the polyester, also two monomers combine with each other and small molecule of water is eliminated. So that is what we have concern about the carboxylic acid in case of the organic compounds. So organic compounds itself, hydrocarbon and its derivative. Now one more thing is there are also inorganic polymers available. So in case of the inorganic polymers, those are a number of examples, but those are inorganic ones. So there is lot of difference between the inorganic compounds and organic compounds. Organic compounds are the hydrocarbon, hydrogen and carbon containing compounds with other elements, whatever those elements are given in the form of the functional group, for example oxygen. So here we have discussed about the polyester. So in case of the polyester, we have seen that hydroxy group and carboxylic group, both functional groups are combined and form a new functional group, that is the polyester group. So therefore hydrocarbon and its derivatives, this is one of the very simple definition of organic compounds. Now different polymers. So what about the polymers when we have to back to the history in 1935, 1925, 28, in those particular days the bakelite was invented as well as the nylons were invented. So that is the part of the 20th century. So in mid of the 20th century, lots of polymers were developed. Even in 1963, for this purpose, one of the Ziegler and Natta both got the Nobel Prize for the invention of the Ziegler-Natta catalyst. So that catalyst also used for the polymerization purposes. So how polymers are formed, what were the different conditions, the temperature condition, the pressure condition, and whatever that particular reactors are there. So the designing of reactor is also one of the concern. So here we can say that different polymers are obtained from the petroleum products. Whatever we have, suppose we have to go back to the petroleum refinery, and in those petroleum refining, number of carbon compounds are liberated. So for example, in that particular case, two carbon atom hydrocarbon is liberated. So that two carbon atom hydrocarbon itself undergo the process of different processing, and then we get the polymer. Earlier, back to the about 4 to 5 decade ago, the polyester, that is the synthetic yarn, that is also the terrene, that is the dacron. So synthetic polymer, synthetic fibers, we all of you will know about the cotton. Cotton itself is one of the example of natural polymer, but natural fiber, whatever we are wearing the clothes, so that particular cloth, if that is the artificial, then artificial fibers are the polyester. So polyester have also great role since last 4 and 5 decades, because earlier the clothes were of only the cotton, but because of the petroleum refining, petroleum gives the different raw material, and those different raw material are converted into the different polymers. However, polythene is also one of the petroleum based. So here, with the help of the petroleum refining, small molecules are generated, and those small molecules are separated, and those separation, after separation, there is the so many reaction occurs, and therefore the polymers are prepared. For example, if suppose we have the two carbon atom, carbon double bond carbon, that is the ethylene. So ethylene undergo the process of the polymerization, and this gives us the polythene. Now the question is, what is the mechanism behind the polymerization? So all of you well known about that, that is the chemical bonding. So how the bonds are breaked and new bonds are formed. Back to the chemical theory of bonding, before that we have to see the covalent electrons. So in case of the carbon, there is the valence electrons are 4. So carbon can combine with 4 single bond, one thing. Another, carbon can form 1 double bond and 2 single bond. So 1 double bond and 2 single bond. So tetravalency of carbon is satisfied for that. So similarly, carbon triple bond, carbon, that is the acetylenes. So in case of acetylene, the carbon triple bond carbon is there, and then the single bond which is linked with the another monovalent groups, monovalent functional group, or whatever we have the another elements. So here we can say the, for example, if we have to see the carbon triple bond carbon, so this is the acetylene. So acetylene also undergo the process of the polymerization, and then polyacetylenes will be there. So number of polymers are prepared, and we have to see the basic of the polymerization. The process is the polymerization. Polymerization is the process in which monomers are converted into the polymers. We have one of the example, and that is the example is the natural rubber. So natural rubber, in that particular case, also the polymerization where the polyisoprene, that is the monomer, polyisoprene that having the carbon double bond carbon and two carbon double bond carbon are there in case of the isoprene, and we have to see the structure of isoprene, carbon double bond carbon, then further carbon double bond carbon. So that is two double bonds are there in case of the isoprene. So 1,3, that is the buta, because four carbon atom and two double bonds are there. So that compound is the 1,3-butadiene. So 1,3-butadiene is the whatever that is the network. And in this particular case, at the second carbon atom, the methyl group is substituted, and that become 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene. So that is the natural rubber monomer, and this undergo the process of the polymerization, then we get the natural rubber. That is whatever we are using for the to rub the pencil mark rubbers. So that is the natural rubber. But during the World War, World War Second in 1939 to 1945, during that particular period, there was concentration of the natural rubber in some countries. So at that moment, artificial rubbers were investigated, and those invented. So there was the base 1,3-butadiene. So poly-1,3-butadiene, that they have assumed that there may be the rubber. So at that moment, new synthetic rubbers were investigated during the 1939 to 1945. So let's we have what is the process, how polymers are formed. The fundamentally, in case of the organic compound, all of you are well known that one of the when bond is cracked. So bond, chemical bond in the organic compound, and that is the covalent bond. I have one of the video lecture series, and you can all of you can see that particular video on the covalent bonding. So covalent bonding is there, and all of you are well known about that, how covalent bond is formed. That is because of the sharing of electron. So one electron from one atom, and so they have the sharing of electron, and then they form a covalent bond. Here one more important concern, the chemical theory of bonding in covalent bond is the hybridization process, and that chemical theory of bonding was given, the well-known Pauling. So here one more thing is there, hybridization process is the interaction of different atomic orbitals and formation of new hybrid orbitals. So let's we have to see those particular hybridization is most important concern in the process of the polymerization. So what happened? sp3 hybridization, that is tetrahedral hybridization. sp2, that is the trigonal. In that particular case, the 120 degree angle is there, so trigonal. And whatever in case of the sp hybridization, the linear shape, 180 degree centigrade bond angle between the two bonds. So let's we have to see the polymerization. In case of the polymerization, what happened? Carbon double bond carbon undergo the ring and the one bond opening. Carbon double bond carbon, here the single sigma bond, and here another is the pi bond. So this pi bond when open, okay, so here the carbon having sp2 hybridization in case of the ethyls. So carbon double bond carbon is there. So what we have, that particular pi bond is breaked. So what happened? The hybridization on the carbon atom, it changed. And what type of hybridization? Earlier, in case of ethylene, the carbon having two type of peptides, but when pi bond break down and that linked with another molecule of ethylene. So similarly, another carbon double bond carbon ethylene molecule also break down, and then they link with each other. And what were they linking? And that is the polymer. Polymers where high molecular weight compounds are obtained. Now, this type of polymerization is the addition type. So certainly, addition of molecule. So we can say here the different addition, that particular addition polymerization. So think about that, the addition polymerization is what? Addition polymerization itself is what we have to see. That particular addition polymerization itself is because of the two or more monomer added to each other. So let's we have to continue, and another type of polymerization also occur. Although we are well known, whatever I have given, the polyester as well as the nylons. Polyester and nylons where very small molecule is the eliminated condensation of that. So here the another type of polymerization is the condensation polymerization. Now one more polymerization is the copolymerization. So copolymerization is the same as addition polymerization. So what the difference is there? In copolymerization, two or more monomers are used, and then they form a new type of polymer. And there are number of examples which are available. They have, for example, we have the styrene butadiene rubber. So styrene one monomer, and then butadiene another monomer. They combine with each other and form high molecular weight, that is the styrene butadiene rubber. And this is one of the well-known polymer, because this is the example of the adhesive material. And this so styrene butadiene rubber, this one is the copolymer. So let's we have to continue for what type of here we can see. And now we have already discussed the monomer and polymers. Okay, here inorganic polymers are also available, for example polysilicon, and the synthetic polymers as well as the natural polymer, this is the silica. So silica cell is the natural inorganic polymer. Then we have the organic polymers. In case of the organic polymers, the natural polymers are proteins, the carbohydrate, fats, where we can see other whatever the concern of the genes, the DNA. So DNA, RNA, all those are the natural polymers, because those present in the nature in the form of different plants, in the as well as different animals. So now we can continue the reaction mechanism. All of you are well known about whatever the reactive intermediates. I have also video lecture, so you can all of you are to see the video lecture on the reactive intermediate. So that clearly indicates the reaction mechanism in the organic compound. One more thing is there, and that particular thing is there, how bond is wrecked and what conditions are required, which bond is weaker and which bond is stronger. All of you well know, we have already discussed the sigma bond, and sigma bond, the formation by with the overlapping of the different orbitals, either atomic orbitals or the hybrid orbital. Different hybrid orbitals are there, sp2 hybrid orbitals, that with the carbon double bond carbon. Now we have to see the reaction mechanism. So regarding the reaction mechanism, when any of the compound that contains the organic compound, that particular organic compound break down. So during the breaking of bond, some intermediate species are formed. How all of you can see that what are the intermediate species? So going back to the breaking of carbon-carbon bond, carbon-hydrogen bond, carbon-nitrogen bond, whatever that particular different elements attached to the carbon. If suppose carbon single bond, nitrogen bond, whether this can be break down, carbon single bond, oxygen, whether this can be break down, carbon double bond, oxygen, so carbon single bond, oxygen, whatever those, the breaking of the bond, as all of you well know, that organic compounds are covalent in nature, and covalent bonds are there, so covalent bond, when break down, then we get intermediate species. One thing, the intermediate species may be ionic or the free radical. Ionic, the name ions is there. So what about the meaning of ion? What are the ions? Ions, how the ions are formed? This is one of the simple, and we have the periodic table. Sodium lose one electron, sodium cation is formed. So what is the charge on the sodium? Positive charge. Chlorine accept the electron, so therefore the charge on chlorine, negative charge, that become the chloride. So chloride there, sodium cation is there. So that is the what we have the general concept of the ion formation. Now in case of the organic compounds, how ions are formed? We have to see the covalent bond, the covalent electrons. So covalent electrons are the shared electron. If one atom and another atom, then both having the electron pair. And this electron pair itself is the carbon bond, covalent bond. But when the reaction conditions, when we have to give the temperature optimum conditions, then that particular bond is breaked. So that particular, here the fission of the bond occurs, and the fission, the breaking of bond may be whatever the reaction condition. If the electron of this atom is go to there, so what happened? That becomes the anion, carbon anion. And if suppose that particular electron which have the electron used for the covalent bonding is not in this case, that become the cation. So that is the carbon cation. So here carbon cations are the carbonium ion, as well as carbon anions are the carbon anion. And if suppose both goes to each of, if suppose one atom and two atom, the covalent bonding, and after breaking they go homolytic fission. During the homolytic fission, free radical reactions are there. Free radical intermediate species are generated. So we can say those in reaction mechanism in the of organic compounds, in case of the polymerization, nucleophile, electrophile, the name is itself, and those are the ionic, so that is heterolytic fission, nucleophile or electrophile or free radical. So free radicals have whatever each species goes to there. So methyl free radical may be there, methyl carbonium ion may be there, and methyl anion, methyl carbon anion, whatever the concept of the anion and cation we are giving. So carbon anion, negative charge, carbonium ion, the positive charge. So that concept is the same. Whatever we get, the positive charge ion and negative charge anion, and there is no charge, those are the free radical. So in this particular case of the polymerization, those things are very, so here we can get the reactive intermediates, electrophiles, free radicals as well as nucleophile. So what we have to continue the other parts, and that is the polymerization process. So in case of the polymerization process, addition polymer, copolymer, I have given the example of the copolymer, styrene. Styrene is the vinyl benzene, and this combined with 1,3-butadiene. So 1,3-butadiene and styrene both link with each other. How they form? Because carbon double bond carbon is present in each of the monomer. So what happened? The carbon double bond carbon of this molecule, two different molecules are break down, that is the pi bond, and then they link with each other. So those are the copolymerization process, and this is a different monomers are there, and this concept is also very useful, and we get different polymers, and even the functional polymers are obtained for this purpose. Different whatever number of polymers that are required for different technology. So here, and regarding the concern condensed polymerization, this is the same whatever the same we have discussed. Why the examples polyester? I have given the example of the polyester, as well as I have given the example of the nylon polyamides. So here, the condensed polymerization, so three different types of polymerization will be there: addition, copolymer, addition polymerization. Various examples are polyethylene, polyvinyl chloride, polypropylene, polystyrene, with the addition polymers. Then whatever we have, that is regarding the polyisoprene, that is the natural rubber. Then we have the other different types of rubber, and that is the neoprene. So neoprene is the polymer of the chloroprene. So those are the addition polymers. So addition polymer is this. What we have, only one monomer is there, whereas in case of copolymer, two or more monomers are represent, and then they get whatever one, two, they alternate, whatever there may be the three also, or whatever the four. So that depends, that is the special conditions required for that purpose. So here SBR, this is one of the adhesive material. How this can be formed? Latex, styrene, butadiene, rubber. So that is the copolymer. In case of the condensed polymer, polyester, polyamides, these are the synthetic material, synthetic polymers. Now we have to see the another part, and free radical and electrophilic. Now this is the well-known whatever we have discussed. There are here one more whatever the, that in case of the condensation polymer, however, that is the one, but condensation here one more addition, the coordination polymerization. However, this is we have the include in the addition polymerization. So coordination polymerization is well known, great Nobel laureate, those are the Ziegler and Natan. So in that particular case, the coordination polymerization appears. Condensation, this is the step growth polymerization, copolymerization. So we have discussed all those polymerization. Now we can say addition, the chain growth polymerization. Here, in case of the addition polymerization, in this type of polymerization, the molecule of same monomer or different monomer, whatever I have given the example, at the large scale to form the polymer. The monomer accordingly employed in the type of polymerization contains a carbon-carbon bond, unsaturated compounds, example generally alkenes, whatever I have discussed, carbon double bond carbon, where the derivatives that can be participate in the chain reaction. So therefore the chain is the form. So in this particular chain reaction, whatever the starting, the initial initiation of chain, then propagation and termination. Three different steps are there in case of the addition polymerization. In condensation polymerization, this type of polymerization generally involves condensation, a repetitive condensation reaction. Two molecules will join together, resulting in the loss of small molecule between two bifunctional monomer. Whatever the bifunctional, here example, the carboxylic acid and hydroxy group. So two bifunctional monomers are there, and those combine with each other and new ester bond is formed. Whatever carboxylic group combined with the hydroxy group is the alcohol. So here we have one of the, all of you know, we can take the, for the polyester preparation, the glycol. So what about the glycol? Dihydroxy alcohol. So here ethylene glycol, where one hydroxy and another hydroxy. Similarly, here we have also the dicarboxylic acid, where the benzene ring and then carboxylic group. So carboxylic group combined with the hydroxy group of ethylene glycol. So therefore, the next unit combined with the next of the dicarboxylic acid, and that is the terthalic acid. So terthalic acid, which 1 and 4 both in benzene ring, 1 and 4 there is the bonds, carboxylic groups are there. So therefore, a new bond is formed, and here a small molecule like water is separated. So those are the polyesters, as well as when we have to discuss about the polyamides. So in case of the polyamide, those are the nylon, those are the proteins. In that particular case, we get the condensation polymers. Now another, this is one of the example. Here we can say that diamine, whatever the both side have the amine group and both side have carboxylic group. So here the water is liberated and we get the carbon double bond oxygen and amide bond is formed. So there is the amino acids in themselves, that is also well known example. Now we have come towards the different questions, and what we have the query, how this process occurs, what is the meaning of the polymerization, which conditions the polymers occurs, the ionic polymerization, which is the free radical or the nucleophilic. So here ionic polymerization is carried out at this so here the answer itself is the temperature at which the ionic polymerization is carried out at the 00 degree centigrade. Ionic polymerization is the chain growth polymerization in which active center are ions or the ion polymers. Here the new question, which of the following monomer cannot be polymerized by radical polymerization? Which this thing I have earlier discussed, that is the reaction mechanism, in which of the reaction mechanism the bond itself is break down in two ways. One is the ionized form and another is the radical. So radical, whatever the name, free radicals are formed. So here we have to see the polymerization in the form of electrophilic, that is the free radical polymerization. Even and there is also the electrophilic addition reaction. So free radical addition reaction. I think all of you have well known about the free radical addition and electrophilic addition in case of the alkenes. So there, alkenes, this special condition is required for the free radical addition reaction. So the same thing as in alkene, whatever I think all of you know about the addition reactions in case of the alkenes, and those are the free radical addition reaction as well as the electrophilic addition reaction. But what about the major difference? The major difference is the reactant, and in that particular case, the free radicals are generated by, all of you well known about that, the peroxides. So peroxides produce that is the condition for that. So in case of the free radical addition reaction, so this is which of the following monomer cannot be polymerized by radical polymerization. This is the question. The butadiene, are free radical, isobutylene, in this particular case, what happened? Are you know, all of you know the structure of isobutylene. So in this particular case, isobutylene monomer can be polymerized by cationic polymerization. Cationic, that is the electrophilic, whatever the addition reaction. So cation, I have earlier discussed how cations are formed because of the electrode is not there. Whatever I have discussed that the bone fission, in which the bone fission, whether this electrode, the bearing electrode goes to another one. So therefore, this remains the cation and this becomes the anion. So cation itself is the electrophile. So here, isobutylene monomer can be polymerized by cationic polymerization, butadiene. What will be the polymer of butadiene? Polybutadiene. What is the structure of chemical structure of butadiene? CH2, double bond CH, then single bond CH, then double bond CH2. So 1,3 butadiene. So this one is the invented during, because the Second World War, there was the shortage of natural rubber. So whatever the great scientists have invented, first of all, they find what is the monomer unit in natural rubber, that they have find the isoprene. And what is the skeleton of isoprene? 1,3 butadiene. So therefore, butadiene is that one, 1,3 butadiene. So here, the correct answer, whatever in this vinyl chloride. What about the vinyl chloride? I have also one of the video lectures, so all of you can see the polyvinyl chloride, which very excellent polymer is there, and excellent properties of PVC, that is the PVC, electrical. In case of the electrical engineering, electrical appliances, electrical cable, PVC itself is used, and that is the vinyl polymer. Acrylates, whatever the acrylates have also great value and polymerized by the radical. So radical itself is the free radical reaction. Free radical addition reaction and electrophilic addition reaction. Next one, the polymerization in which propagating center do not undergo either transfer or termination reaction. This is called living polymerization. Whatever, this is the new technique here, the transfer or termination reactions is called living polymerization. Is the process in which reacting monomer molecule together in a chemical reaction form polymer chain or three dimensional. Now the reverse of esterification, what is this? Esterification, esters are formed. So the answer, hydrolysis, condensation not, polymerization not, esterification. So a reverse of esterification is the hydrolysis. Hydrolysis is the reaction that involving the breaking of a bond in a molecule using the water. So water itself is where the hydrogen, oxygen, hydrogen. So what happened? The carboxylic ester, carbon double bond oxygen, and single bond oxygen, then single bond. So that is the carboxylic ester. So carboxylic ester here when undergo, why they are giving the esterification? So what are the, all of you know, the polyester. So polyester, those are formed. So the reverse of that is the hydrolysis. In case of the polyester formation, the condensation. So condensation is not there, polymerization is not there, centrifugation is the physical process. So here the reaction mainly occur between an ion and water molecule and often changes the pH of a solution. Now, the tartaric acid and ethylene glycol, whatever I have discussed earlier, the polysterification to form PET. Answer is correct. What is the full name of the PET? Polyethylene tartalate. So how the polyethylene, ethylene glycol, okay, that is the C carbon double bond carbon and then hydroxy group both of the carbon, dihydric alcohol, that is ethylene glycol, where two hydroxy groups are there, and tartaric acid, that is the benzene ring, here at one position, COH, carboxylic group is there, here at the another end, the carboxylic group is there. So carboxylic group, COH, linked with the hydroxy group. So therefore, the formation of the ester. So similarly, one by one, and long chain polymer is formed. So that particular long chain, you get the polyester. So that is the polyester. Polyethylene tartalate, so tartalic acid, and ethylene glycol undergo the polyesterification. Here the word is given to form polyethylene tartalate. It is the most common thermoplastic polymer resin. What is the meaning of the resin? That is the neat, whatever virgin, that is of the polyester family, and it is used in fiber for clothing. Some of the food containers, whatever the food containers used in the kitchen. So all of you have to see the kitchen in which the various food containers are made up of PET. Those are polyethylene tartalate. So these, whatever the polyethylene tartalate is one of the great application. Here, whatever one of the following is used for making cold drink water. So polyethylene, that is also, all of you know about that is what we have, the answer, which of the following is used for making cold drink water? Magnetic recording tapes, then housing for the coffee machine. So here also is the PET. What is the full form of PET? Polyethylene tartalate. This the same is used for making cold drink bottle, magnetic recording tape, and housing for the coffee machine. So that is we have to see there is the great application of so we have to know the fundamental, that is essential. What are those particular fundamental? The basics of the chemistry, basics of chemistry, and any of the technology development, any of that, either we have the space research, either we have the food research, or we have the whatever the extreme functional values. So suppose we have to make the lightweight vehicles, then definitely the application of polymer is one of the important task. So therefore, different polymers are prepared, and one more thing is there, the polymers have the greater workability. If you know about the workability, because the expansion of the industrial revolution, that is industrial revolution occurs in the present context, that is because of the polymer. What the answer? I know the workability of polymers is very high. If we can compare, for example, if we want to prepare the furniture, for example, we want to prepare chair. So earlier, before, when the polymers were not there, so the chair was prepared by the wood. So what happened? That particular wood is cut down, then they have the finishing. So lots of work will be there. and so that cannot we get the instant cheer. So that is the part of the food cheer, and this then further we can use the metal. So what about the metal? Then we have different processes in the making of the metallic cheer. Okay, now so metallic cheer also needs so many days. First of all, the metallic chair is the welded, whatever the design. So here the workability. So workability time is more and more in case of the wood as well as in case of the metallic chair. But when polymers are there, suppose we have the polyethylene, terephthalate, and that we have to make the whatever the cabinets, whatever the different polymers are used. So what, how we can get the instant? So within 1 hour we get 10,000 number of chair. So this one, this is because of the polymers. So polymers have great opportunity at this moment, and because of the polymer, the expansion of different industries. Otherwise, there is a lots of work has to do. Whatever we have seen, the we can compare the if a chair is of the wood, so wood finishing, wood cutting down, then further finishing, then we have to paint it. So these are the whatever those. And in case of the metallic chair, so metallic chair we need certain different processes. What about the processes when we have the metal? So metal will be designed, and then there is the process is the welding, then the welding, then finishing, then whatever those particular, then finally we get the coating. In this particular case, when these are substituted, for example polyethylene terephthalate, for example various other polyacrylates, whatever the different copolymer which are used for this purpose, even more thing is there, and that is called the whatever these can be easily prepared. Here we need the marketing, because within when we have to see different polymer making machines, so we have only one mold that can be designed with the computer. So what happened? Easily within 1 hour we get the 10,000 pieces. There is the need of the marketing for that. So this process is called the greater workability. So that's why polymers are great opportunity for us, and definitely we have the great materials, whatever that, but if we have the first one more thing is there, these are environment friendly, not environment friendly. So we have to need certain inventions, certain innovations regarding the biodegradable plastics. So that is the concern. So we have to. So now I think all of you can understand with what is the significance of polymerization, the different we get the different products, whatever the adhesive, whatever we have the electric cable, whatever we have the kitchen containers where food is taken, the water bottle, polyethylene terephthalate, the different rubbers. So all those are the miracles in the human life. But one thing is there, and that is environment friendly. So except this one, polymers have the remarkable. However, there is certain going on that we have to make the biodegradable plastics. However, all of you know that polythene is made. So let's we together do the work on alternative, those non-biodegradable polymers. We have to go towards environmental friendly biodegradable. So that needs the more innovation. So I suppose that all of you have get ready to work on the biodegradable plastic. So that is all about us. So thank you for all, whatever the patience, whatever the listening, my video lecture. And I think, I suppose that you get the more and more relevant information, and all those information are the, for the humanity, for the human life, because we need lots of work. I still, because we have see that environment friendly plastic must be there. Okay, all the best. So anyone need, anyone can contact me, whatever my mobile number and whatever my email ID, as well as you all can visit the Gyanvihar University, Suresh Gyanvihar University, which is situated at the Jaipur, Jagatpura. So all the best.